Health equity and healthcare disparities have been a focus of our work for many years. However, the COVID-19 pandemic has really highlighted the need for more work in this area. We have created centers, networks, research grants, pilot grants, and especially community engagement with our communities of color in order to attempt to address healthcare disparities, not only from a research standpoint, from a teaching, as well as a clinical care standpoint.
We believe that building bridges between our academic institution and community health centers is key to health equity. In this particular grant, the partnership allowed us to support Roots in launching a rapid response to meeting the needs of the Spanish-speaking community hardest hit by COVID-19.
A lot of the health disparity research that currently takes place, it's really important for us to center the voice of those that are being researched. And I think that's what Roots Community Health Center is really all about, in making sure that we center their voice in a lot of the research and programmatic offerings that we do and all the services that we deploy.
Yeah, and through like notifying patients that have tested positive for COVID-19, we were realizing that a lot of our patients didn't have devices or internet access. A lot of them didn't have an email or a phone number and relied heavily on family, friends, and neighbors. And that's something we found that we needed to step in and help, is like by addressing those needs and providing devices and internet access to our population and community.
The COVID-19 pandemic presented unprecedented challenges to communities of color, and I became very interested in addressing specifically the infodemic that was affecting this community and their knowledge about COVID and also their willingness to get the COVID vaccine. And so the first project happened early on in the epidemic, where we created a mobile app providing information about testing resources, other community resources locally. The second project was a video that we collaborated with Facebook on. It was a compilation of videos, particularly with healthcare workers, physicians of color, who could tell their personal story and decision making around getting the COVID-19 vaccine. And then that ended up accessing a large population across the world, millions of views, a lot of shares, and we felt like our impact was pretty large, given just a pretty straightforward resource like creating a 1-minute video.
We wanted to understand the utilization of telemedicine in populations, and we looked particularly at the difference between non-Hispanic whites and Hispanics. We found that Hispanics, whether they were English-speaking or Spanish-speaking, still had significantly lower rates of telehealth utilization during the pandemic compared to non-Hispanic whites, who were mainly English speakers. It's clear that we're not going to return to a healthcare system where telemedicine is not a prominent factor of healthcare services. So understanding these differences is truly important.
School meals are critical to reducing food insecurities and also improving child health and academic performance. We're now working with parents to develop a marketing communication intervention in schools to increase participation in school meals. This work is very important to me because it's giving me the opportunity to work with my own Latino immigrant community to advocate for policy change and to improve their community. It's very rewarding for me to see parents advocating in their own communities to see change, even though there's a language barrier.
The Cardinal Free Clinics have had to drastically change because of the pandemic. We had to move from our in-person operations in San Jose and Menlo Park into a telehealth format. And while we had to shift and we had a lower capacity of patients we could serve, we were able to largely maintain the medical services and social resources that we provided to patients, largely due to the strong partnerships we have with community centers and referral sites.
We generally serve a very low-income community, and we wanted to figure out what needs they identify for themselves so that we can best meet those needs. And we are doing this through interviews with our patients and as well as a social needs screening that we developed for the pandemic.
It's important that we identify those needs so we can best serve those patients. So hopefully we can direct them to those important resources. And the students really have, just in this short period of time, identified those and really helped so many patients already.
At this time, we have an opportunity to start to address these issues in ways that we have never been able to do before. This will only serve to improve the health not only of our communities of color, but communities overall in the United States and globally.